So I think maybe something first to ask you guys is, how exactly did you come up with the name?
Like, I don't know what made it here.
We often make up clever stories that make it an interesting one. But there's not one. Patch that we're driving around in my 1987 Toyota Tercel. And that was the first one we thought of that wasn't taken. This was before the interweb, at least before we had it in our homes. So we'd have to go to the Hastings Books Music and Video local music store and go to their little computer that they had to look up, you know, what they had in stock. And there was no CDs by a band called the All-American Rejects in stock, so.
Okay, so how long have you guys been together then?
That was in 1999. And then we met Mike and Chris in 2000. Was it two? Okay.
Well, we may have met.
No, because the first record was already done, so it was 02.
Yeah.
So, almost 8 years now, of course.
All right.
Excuse me.
You guys have a semi-recent album out, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is there any stories behind the songs on that album?
Probably.
Each song is a story. Yeah. I mean, there's. I mean, we could fill your ears with everything from the writing process to the literal meanings of the songs, but it was a record that was, you know, an endeavor for us. And it was 2 years of writing and recording, and it was contentious and fun at the same time, and we were really proud of it. So,
I don't know. Okay, I recommend you give it a listen from beginning to end.
Give it a listen from beginning
to end.
Even
after the last songs, like, you play.
Is there something, like, hidden? Okay. Maybe are there any certain songs that, like, maybe one of you in particular, like, it, you really helped with that, or it's one of your favorites?
I think collectively we all like a song called Another Heart Calls, which is a duet with a female voice, which none of us are chicks, so we don't usually play it. But tonight will be the first time we've ever played a song called Back to Me. That's a song that almost didn't make the record, but we're glad it did after. So you get the first time ever. The record's been out for a year, it's the first time we played this song.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Dude, what, you know, you guys know. Hey, is that guy here the tattoo guy?
He's coming. No, he's coming.
No, he's not coming for you.
Yeah, well, I thought, like, maybe I could be, like, you know, like, in, you know, in with you guys. Maybe?
Tour tag.
Yeah.
You getting tour tag?
Can I be down? You guys?
As long as it's a Friday the 13th tag. real quick.
Sorry, excuse me.
Okay.
I don't know anything. Hold up. Toward regular October 1st.
Sam, you don't
have. They might have some overstock. If not, just get all over. Very important decisions.
Okay, so you guys are doing this tour around college campuses, right?
Lots of shows. Colleges, and lots are at casinos. It's a really fun tour.
Okay, so when exactly did this tour start and when did it end then?
We're about a week and a half down now.
Okay.
November 1st or 2nd? Oh, we have information on a little
piece of
tape. The 3rd is the first show.
Okay.
December 6th is the last.
Alright. So has anything interesting or unusual happened so far?
We had a parking lot party in Boston. We played the same venue 2 nights in a row, and instead of spending money on hotel rooms, all the bands just slept on their buses in the parking lot. And I didn't see the sun come up, but I think a lot of people did. So we got in trouble because there was a lot of broken bottles and trash and people skateboarding loudly.
You know what is unusual is that we're touring with bands that we really like and go along with. Like, not that we don't normally get along with bands to tour with, but there's been, we're kind of old parts now, there's been a generation change, and a lot of these younger bands are just kind of like, they're all nice, but we just don't, they're not like, you know, bros in the city. All the people within our group are. And so it's really cool that we all kind of, I guess, came up around the same time. It's really nice. It's really fun.
So with the shows, do you guys have any like pre-show rituals that you do before you get on stage or?
Well, you take a, you know, we love colleges because there's group showers. No, everybody kind of does their own thing. You know, everybody kind of goes off and does their own vocal warm up. I stretch a little bit. Tyson douses his body in glitter.
I'll be hitting up that gym today.
Yeah.
When there's that, I always say, man,
he likes looking sweaty before the show.
Oh, okay.
Oh, shit. Thank you, Sam.
I think that's pretty much all I have for you guys. Anything you wanted to throw in?
We were disappointed to hear that the Rolling Rock tank closed.
Yeah.
Our manager was hyping us up. We were thinking we were gonna get a tour of the Rolling Rock tour. But we're still stoked to be here. Hope you guys like it.
All right.